Hello, everyone. Welcome to Craft Beer Bucket List with Big Ray and Mike, where we review beers you have to try before you die.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of your favorite craft beer review podcast. I'm Big Ray. On this side or that side of the Arkansas River, just whatever. I haven't got it right the last 3 years. I don't care. Mike is somewhere to my east. He's in Arkansas, and we're going to be talking to you about some awesome stuff tonight. We have three guests in the house. They are chilling currently in our online green room, and we're going to be talking about all kinds of cool stuff where I'm located in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Mike, how are you doing, buddy? I wonder if we lost Mike. So anyway, thank you, technical difficulties. So we have our buddies Larry and Alex on tonight from the Nook Bruco out of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. And I'm laughing right now. If I just said that wrong, one of you guys correct me. Nook Bruco, right? Right. Did I say it right? Oh my God. I'm literally reading it right now on my show notes. You'd think this would not be an issue, but believe it or not, I've goofed that up before. I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to leave it in. I don't care. It's fun. So got the guys on from the Nook, and I also have another special guest on tonight, Debra Wimpee. She is the founder of a badass event that's hosted every year in downtown Broken Arrow called Shamrock the Rose District. And going forward, I'm going to be a little more family friendly as we talk about this. I do apologize. That's just me being me, honey. I'm very sorry. But it's a fantastic family friendly event. And I'll let her talk about this, right? This is her thing. We're here to promote that as well as the Nook. They're going to be joining us at this event. We'll also talk about that later. But how about everybody just say hi real quick. Introduce yourselves to our awesome audience. Alex, go first.
Hi, yeah, thanks. I'm Alex Foster from the Nook Brewing Company.
I'll go. Larry Foster from the Nook Brewing Company.
Deb Wimpee from the great city of Broken Arrow and the founder of Shamrock the Rose. And Mike's still gone.
Woo! And I don't know what happened, but we lost Mike. Again, we know he's in Dardanelle, Arkansas, and I'm not sure that Arkansas really even has internet. I think it's a couple of squirrels doing Morse code on a tree. so they're just really fast at it with those ones and zeros. So I can see Mike is trying to rejoin, so I know he's definitely having some technical difficulties there. Normally there's some insanely useless woody banter between the two of us before we dive in, but it's like, hey, you know what? Stuff happens. It is what it is. We just like to roll with it. We keep everything painfully real here. So I'm so glad that you guys joined us tonight, Alex and Larry, and also Debra. I appreciate y'all being here. So two things we really want to talk about. One, in season 5 of Craft Beer Bucket List, we're featuring a brewery and some of their favorite beers. Tonight, I have the Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde and also the Terminal Velocity Doppelbock. So I'll be sampling both of those and giving my down-to-earth true-life review on those. Mike has had these in the past, but logistics got in my way. I couldn't get these beers in time to him before the recording. You guys can see I've got a couple of crowlers literally in my hand right now. Super excited for these guys. I love both of these beers. I've had them both before. I see Larry smiling big, dude. Just like, oh. He knows it's good what's in there. So we'll talk about some of your other beers, and then we're going to dedicate a good portion of this tonight to promoting Shamrock the Rose District and all of the fun that goes down in that event and how you guys at the Nook got engaged. So lots to talk about. So I don't want to dive into a beer just yet, and bless Mike's heart, we're still waiting on him to get reconnected. But Larry, why don't you just tell us real quick a little bit about the Nook and how you guys got started?
The Nook started actually with a fire pit when we were living in Minnesota. The name came from that. Alex started brewing beer when he was in college. And when we'd get together on weekends or for vacations or something, we'd brew a beer together. When I retired 10 years ago now, we started brewing together a lot, and we started entering a few contests, and we won a gold medal here and there, and people would start calling us saying, man, can you brew that IPA for my wedding or my birthday or whatever? So finally, it was my wife that pushed us over the edge and said, hey, you guys have been talking about this forever. Why don't you either get in or get out, but get all that brew stuff out of my garage? So a couple of bad decisions later, here we are in a brewery and 2.5 years of success. It's been a hoot so far.
Dude, that's awesome. And I love it. So I've heard you guys talk about this before. I've seen it on your website. But we talk about the Nook. I mean, there's two things that come to mind. Like you said, the fire pit. And it's also kind of like a makeshift abbreviation, if you will.
Yeah, so I'll jump in on that part. yeah, when we were always, my friends and I would always get together, became a big hangout spot at that fire pit. So we didn't have a name for it. So it was pretty cumbersome to say, hey, let's go hang out at fire pit at Foster's house. So we were like, we decided we needed to name it something, and we finally landed on the Nook. So it was always, we were bored, let's go to the Nook, or, you know, looking to have a good time, let's have a Nook. So we wanted to carry that same theme over with the brewery. So it was a perfect fit as far as the name is concerned, because we wanted that to be the idea that you want to go hang out with friends, go to the Nook. You're looking for something.
Oh, there you go.
Let's Nook. So, and then also, yeah, we were very pleased to find out that it worked out so that the NO for Northern and OK for Oklahoma. So the shortened version of Northern Oklahoma works out for the Nooks. So yeah.
That's cool.
Things come together sometimes. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely they do. If only we can get Mike's internet together as seamlessly as Northern Oklahoma in the Nook. Bless his heart.
Northern Arkansas.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. So I was like, I'm talking to him on the side, like he is so agitated. He's like, I can't get Zencaster to come up. So I'm not hating on you guys at Zencaster. In case you listen, you're an awesome hosting platform. But sometimes technical difficulties happen. So please don't take away my account. I love you guys. So, but I'm going to dive into a beer here in just a minute. Debra, do you mind talking us a little bit about Shamrock, how you got started and how long it's been going on? I want the listeners to really get a feel for what this is.
Yeah. So technically this should be my 10th year to put it on. But I did not hold it in 2017 due to my election. And then I didn't hold it in 2021 due to that, you know, that virus thing that took place. But we slid in 2020. Just by this, I mean, literally within days before the world shut down. So that was cool. I started Shamrock originally because we didn't have a St. Patrick's Day event in Broken Arrow. And I just decided we should just make one. And so the first year was not a benefit of it. It was just a street festival. There was not the beer garden and all of that. But it was the next year that I got partnered up with Soldier's Wish, and they do an awesome job of meeting unmet needs of veterans. And I just thought they're local and they provide wishes that they grant to veterans. And it's all local, which I love that. And it was just a great opportunity to partner with them and, put the festival together. And then we added the beer garden because, as you know, we don't have a beer festival in Broken Arrow. And so I kind of like doing things that we don't have. I like to just make things happen. If we don't have it, let's just do it. So I didn't drink beer. I knew nothing about beer, but I put together a beer festival. And now this is the seventh year for the garden. So. And it just keeps growing and growing. But it's the largest part of the donation. The revenue from the ticket sales is the largest part of the donation that I get to give to Shamrock or Soldier's Wish.
Alistair, can you tell us a little bit? Oh, sorry, Larry.
But seltzer, Deb.
Well, yeah. I was going to say, Larry's going to make fun of me because my favorite beer at the Nook is the seltzer. So.
There you go. And to top it up, you know, I have tried hundreds of seltzers, and there's probably 110 of the 111 I've tried that I don't like. I don't like seltzer, but I don't hate the one at the Nook.
He didn't say he likes it, but he doesn't hate it.
And it's, full disclosure, I've said this to many brewery owners and head brewers. I'm like, man, I'll try all nine you have on tap. I'm probably going to hate all nine. I just don't like them. But your guys, it's like, it's not my favorite thing in the world, but full disclosure, I can drink it. And it's like, you know, this is a bad. So I'll please don't hate on me. Right. It just doesn't speak to my palate at all. It's usually like drinking just straight styrofoam, like staticky styrofoam. I don't enjoy it. I even tried the Sonic ones when they first came out a couple years. I was so excited. I'm a huge fanboy of Sonic. And I gave away 11 of the 12 cans in that box I bought. I tried one. Is like, nope, not for me. So, and I'm giving you guys mad kudos by saying that, right? I hope you understand that. I've tried so many seltzers from so many states in the U.S., and that's just not for me.
That's like what Alex always says. That's what we shoot for. We're not bad here.
No, and I mean, coming from a guy that's drank, I don't know, I'm somewhere in the 1,000 range, 1,000 plus at this point. I've had a lot of beers, and your guys' stuff is good. I don't say that just because I visit you guys and we talk. When I, you know, y'all have some really good beer. It's like legit good. So I don't know what weight that carries to y'all, award-winning beer makers, just a dude in Broken Arrow that loves beer saying it's good. It's like, no, it's y'all got some good stuff. So I appreciate you guys being here. So, but Debra, I want to circle back to Shamrock real quick. Can you tell us a little bit more about Soldier's Wish and what they do, and what brought you on to start to raise money for them?
Yeah. So it actually started with Representative Kevin McDougall. I met him when he worked for Congressman Bridenstine at the time, and he stepped down to help create Soldier's Wish. And they have now been around 10 years. So I actually partnered with them about a year after they created their organization. But you know how like a lot of veteran organizations are like specific, right? They have specific missions. So Folds of Honor is college funds for, you know, veteran, their children. And Wounded Warriors has its, you know, its mission that it does. And so Soldier's Wish is able to kind of almost like Eagle Ops stand in the gap and just meet unmet needs. So, for instance, you can nominate a family member or a loved one that you know has, you know, a need that could just be help in their daily life, right? So maybe someone is like in a wheelchair and needs ADA remodeling for their bathroom or something. We can come inside, come along with Soldier's Wish and maybe a building company and help create that ADA ramp into their home or into their, make their bathrooms compliant. We've helped pay for medical bills. I know like one time there was a gentleman that he loved woodworking and but he didn't have the funds obviously to buy all the stuff that you would need. And he was able to, like Soldier's Wish is able to get all the, like the saws and all of that good stuff. So just fun stuff like that, that just helps, you know, make a difference in people's lives. And so that's what Soldier's Wish comes along and does. Alex, what are you laughing at? You're distracting me.
I'm so sorry. My daughter just showed up.
I was teasing him about his daughter and she just showed up.
I heard what sounded like some 8-bit video game music kind of in the background there. I'm assuming she's playing a handheld device or something, or was that somebody's cell phone ringtone?
That was me. Sorry.
Oh, no, it's all good, man. Not stressed out here. You know, something that we haven't mentioned yet, and Debra, I'm going to plug myself here just a little bit. I got invited by Debra's team to come in and take over the responsibility for coordinating the beer garden this year.
Yeah.
So when I talked to Joe, the guy that had it last year, it was so hard for me to not just be like all giggling, jumping around when we met at Taco Bell here in South Broken Arrow. Free plug to Taco Bell, by the way. I was like, oh my God, I get to help out with this. Yeah, I get to be in the beer garden. You know, I'm like a massive little kid, right? That's just my personality. But it's like, all right, man. It's like I'm a project manager in my day job. I feel like I have the ability to just put something together. I'm fortunate. I know a lot of folks in the Oklahoma craft beer industry. I've got some good contacts. I feel like I can take this ball and run with it. And so I've been doing my darndest to fill these giant shoes, right, that Debra has got for us and everyone else has been in this position. And for me, it's an honor, and I'm super glad to be a part of this. And so I'm glad that, you know, you and Larry and Alex, I'm pointing at the screen like people know what I'm doing here. But I'm grateful for folks like Alex and Larry can just walk up in the brewery like, hey, can I have a beer? And also, y'all going to hang out with us this year at Shamrock? And so great conversation. We got the ball moving quickly.
And so grateful for you guys. Sign up. Twice, actually.
I believe so. Twice. Yeah, we got you down on the Google sheet twice. And I plan on leaving it there. I get to see the two line items here. I'm like, oh, the Nook. And I read down. It's like, oh, the Nook. Yeah. So, see it twice.
That's just in case you missed it.
Yes.
So, yes, absolutely. So that's super fun for me to see. So it's a big deal for me. Like, craft beer bucket list gets to be engaged in this, you know, just if nothing else, by way of contacting folks, right? Instagram is a wonderful tool. I've reached out to so many breweries by Instagram. I'm like, hey, can y'all make it this year? Help me out. And that's really facilitated a lot of additional breweries coming in to join us this year, again, to raise money for Soldier's Wish. And that for me is a super big deal. Everyone in the craft beer industry is awesome. And it looks like Mike is back. Mike, are you with us, buddy?
I see you. Can you hear me?
Oh, it's Mike.
Oh, man. This is so nice.
Yeah.
I want to apologize for my technical difficulties. I was going to ask how many breweries you got signed up so far.
So as of today, recording date is February 6th. We have 15 breweries signed and confirmed to join us.
That's a big deal. I think it might be the most. I think that's two over what we had last year. So,
bigger and better.
That's awesome. Right.
I mean, I'm expecting big things from Big Ray. So,
I'm not done working it yet. I still have time. I told you my goal was 20. I'm still shooting for that. We'll see what happens, right? I'm not going to, jinx myself, if you will, but. I'm not done yet. I'm still gunning for bigger.
Yes.
So, and we've got a couple other folks. If you don't mind, I want to just name drop a couple other folks that are helping us out inside the beer garden. One was one of our season four sponsors on Craft Beer Bucket List, but Boozy Jerky is coming out. They're not only going to have a vendor booth set up in the main area, they're going to have a booth set up in the beer garden. They're going to be giving out samples of beer jerky to as many folks as they can. And we're going to have a couple social media giveaways, and folks are going to have to pick up what they won inside the beer garden at the event. So be sure to buy your tickets online, get them cheaper before you come out. Also, if you win their prize pack, boop, have more jerky at the event. And also our friends at Super Mikado Morelos, they're going to be setting up a booth for us as well to give out some tasty treats. So super excited to have our friends from Morelos join us. And that on top of some pretzels and bowls and some other snacks that'll be available. But we got two, big players out there to feed all of us hungry beer drinkers. I say us, I don't get to drink. I'll be busy working that day, but that's fine. Everybody that comes out will get some yummy treats while they're getting some amazing craft beer. So I'm super stoked for that this year.
Yeah, I was excited to hear that Super Mercados was going to be bringing out some snacks. They actually stopped by my house last night to bring me some chicharrones, and I guess that's what they're going to be bringing out to the beer festival. So I'm like, it's my favorite.
Yes.
So that's great.
Oh,
and I just like
so
chicharrones.
Right? So good. Like, every time I go to that store, I buy like 10 pounds of meat more than I need just because I need a snack for the mile ride to my house from their store. And I get home, it's like, oh my God, I'm so full. I need to wash this down with the beer. imagine that. So, but while we're talking about beer, I want to crack into this Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde.
Hey, while you crack into that, Ray, one thing that I kind of struck talking with you on some of these things coming up on Shamrock the Rose. Yeah. One of the things that seems to always get to people is the line trying to get in. And one of the things that Ray has talked to us about, and I think is a great idea, is a pre-sale for the VIP entrance, where you don't have to wait in line. Like, it's always an annoyance for everybody at every beer festival I've been to. If you can come in a day or two early, pick up your wristband, walk right in, boom, you're in the book garden, everything's good to go. That makes a world of difference in all this stuff.
Yeah.
Should be great.
Yes. So we're still working out the logistics of that, Larry, but you're 100% on point. I plan on joining you guys at the Nook on Friday, March the 10th, to check people's IDs and also check their name off the registry list. We have to make sure that we are 100% compliant with what we're doing. We're not here to break any rules. And we're also going to have a volunteer posted up at Babco, Broken Arrow Brewing Company, also our friends in town, the craft beer industry. And we'll have two locations where folks can go. They can pick and choose which one, either one. Doesn't matter, whatever's more convenient for them. We'll check their IDs. We'll check them off the list and make sure they put that wristband on.
Yes.
Right, physically on. Because if it comes off, my bad, love you, but you're going to have to get another one. And they're not free. Right, I'll just say that now. I'm setting the standard for everybody. You take a shower and it falls off, not my bad. You're all grown ups. You can handle your bracelet. Sorry.
You can handle 24 hours. Come in.
Yes, you can make it a day. I mean, come on. Goodness. Hey, so, Ray, yes, we're absolutely working that out. Yes.
You're going to be happy. Instead of, you remember how we talked about the wristbands and the little white tabs and all that? I went ahead and forged and did plastic wristbands, so we don't have to worry about that.
Oh, hey.
Oh, awesome.
Even better.
Oh, that's great.
No,
so they can't take a shower before they come.
Yeah.
That's cool. Awesome.
Oh, that's good times. That's good news. I appreciate that.
I meant to tell you.
So that'll be super helpful.
Yes.
Oh, hey, no, I'm excited to hear about it here. That's great news. So I think that all of that's great. I do, but also this, and I'm drinking straight from a crowler. It's like a big Ray. Like, you just do things. I don't know how many people are just going to do that. I do prefer to pour. It does.
It looks right? Proportionate.
It fits well.
Yeah.
Right. Like, I pick up a 2-liter of soda sometimes and just drink out of that, and it looks like a 20-ounce bottle in my hand. It's what it is.
Ray, what kind of beer are you drinking?
So here I'm taking. So I've got the Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde. I'm starting with that. So I feel like I'm doing a light to dark with my two beers here. And correct me if I'm wrong, Alex and Larry, but I believe the Vanilla Blonde is going to be lighter than the Doppelbach.
Very much so.
That's okay, because I can't see through the crowler. And you know, as I drink it, I can't see it. But oh, man, I'm not the brightest bulb in the box on Monday nights, y'all. My apologies. Hey,
yeah, I can say it. Tell us about the beer.
That actually fits. Yeah, so like the two beers you have actually fit what we try to do really well. So what we like to do is we like to have just a shotgun blast of beer styles, a really wide variety, because that's what people really enjoy with craft beer. That's what makes it fun. That's what we try to base everything off of, is, you know, because it's fun. People like to try different things and new things, but they also like to have some good classics that they just enjoy a lot. So we have a variety of fun flavor stuff like this, where it's just an easy drinking blonde ale with the, you know, rich vanilla aroma and flavor to it. Kind of different than you can get in a lot of places. And then you got the Doppelbach, which is a classic German style, just a dark lager. So, you encapsulated what we try to do really well with the two beers you picked.
So, dude, I hate to just say it's so good, but it's so good. It's super vanilla forward, which I'm a big fan of. Vanilla is one of my favorite overall flavors. And one thing I notice about this beer, if I leave it sit in my mouth for a minute and just let it warm up, it almost has like a malty backbone about it. And for me, that's a little unexpected for what I'm drinking. And tell me if that's, if there's another term or other stuff, but that's what it feels like to me. A nice maltiness to it. But dude, it's so vanilla forward. Very smooth mouthfeel, medium body beer. It's such an easy drinker, man. This is so sessionable. And I feel like this would pair with 80% of ice creams on the market today. And for me, beer and ice cream pairings are a big deal. It's like, I'm a grown up. I do what I want. I like beer and ice cream. Judge me if you must. That's a big deal for Big Ray.
You're 100% right with everything you just said. I mean, it's just a 5% beer, so it totally is sessionable. You can sit there and drink those all night if you want. So for anniversary parties every year, we release... On our first year anniversary, we released 8 new beers, and this past year we released 7 new beers. And that Vanilla Blonde was actually one of our special releases at the anniversary party that got a lot of really good feedback from people. People wanting us to do it as a full scale, so now it's a staple on our menu. Hasn't left since.
Outstanding. So I know I've had a good number of these. Like I'm a big fan. I've had this more than once. So when I got this one, I was like, oh yeah, woo, big fan. So I'm curious, is this going to be one of the beers that you're bringing with you to Shamrock the Rose District?
Of course. Yep.
That and seltzer, you can say
yeah. No pressure, guys. I'm just, nope, I'm just curious what you're bringing. Don't feel obligated because we said it here.
No, we're going to bring the Vanilla Blonde, Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde, our Irish Red, and our seltzer is what we'll be bringing.
Oh, dude, that is such a good variety pack to have on tap for everybody. For me, that's exciting. It's like, rock solid. So, except for the seltzer, I'm sure other people are going to love that. Like, yay. And I'm like, I'll stick to the Crazy Town.
Wow. Ray.
But you're bringing the seltzer, right? Because I may find my way into the garden at some point. And so I may be thirsty.
Deb, you're always at the gate. We always want to take care of you.
Oh my goodness. But this year we're going to get people at the gate that could actually handle it, I think. It's going to be great.
Yes. Absolutely. And so, Larry, please don't take it like I'm beating up your seltzer, because I'm not, brother. I am not at all. I hope you know that. I really do.
You're just beating up on seltzers in general.
Yeah.
Just yes. Not you guys or your seltzer. Just in general.
Yeah. He does not love yours, but he doesn't hate it. So that's good. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
That's good.
So I hope you guys don't take that bad. I don't mean it in a bad way, I promise. I know my words don't always represent what I'm thinking. I think that's my ADHD coming out, but hey, you know, it's I'm gonna stop making excuses for myself. So I do want to crack into this Terminal Velocity Doppelbock as well. And while I'm opening this up and enjoying my first few drinks, Larry, can you tell us a little bit about this beer?
Doppelbock. It's a pretty straight up Doppelbock. It's one of our most popular, really a nice malty front kind of a flavor and a real nice caramel finish when you end. So it's a really easy drinking, one of our most popular, really easy drinking beers.
Can I just hug one of you guys right now? Is that
Alex? Alex is the brains behind the group.
It's like, dude, it's like going from the vanilla right to this. I mean, I almost feel like I could make a beer float with both of these in the same glass as my vanilla ice cream. Not that I'm a huge fan of blending beers, but I think they would just go so well together. Like you said, it has a lot of caramel notes. It's got some light toffee flavor, so it's definitely got some sweetness about it, but it's not overwhelming. Fantastic mouthfeel, right? This is just very clean. It sits well on the palate. As another one, as I swish it around in my mouth and just let it kind of warm up, you kind of get some other identifiable notes. And like a wine for me, it's like it's very complex. I know a Cicerone wouldn't use the word complex the same way, but I'm just a regular dude. That's how I talk about it. I'm not CBS certified, right? But to just your average listener, it's like, dude, this is just another wonderful sessionable beer. It offers a lot, and I think it's going to speak to a lot of different you know, I'm trying to say two things at once. it's going to speak to a wide audience. So if you have an IPA drinker, I believe it's got enough here. They're going to go for that. If you've got somebody that's into just pilsners and light lagers, this isn't so heavy or so full of flavor, it's going to turn them off. This is going to speak to a lot of people. And I believe, you know, actually both of these are going to be what I call a gateway beer. Somebody that's new to craft beer, they don't really know what they want. I believe this is one you can point them to and they're not going to be overwhelmed and they're kind of going to be hooked on craft beer, right? So Mike and I, we call those the gateway beers. Introduce people to quote unquote good beer, right? I think you guys know what I'm trying to say without saying it. But still, they're good enough, right? They're high enough quality, enough flavor. It's also going to speak to craft beer veterans, right? So very, very high quality beer. I'm a huge fan. And I also want this with ice cream. Like, yay.
And just because, just to kind of make sure we repeat the date, it's March 11th, right?
Yes.
That is correct. Saturday, March
11th. At what time do the gates open?
And the beer garden is, yep, 5 to 9 p.m. is the garden time.
All right.
So 4 hours of unlimited sampling of the finest local brews. Right? Right? Is that right?
That's right.
Absolutely. That is absolutely right.
Absolutely true.
And two things I want to highlight, because Mike and I just recently visited Frostfest in Fayetteville, Arkansas. And two highlights for me from that is, one, the pretzel necklace. I want to encourage everybody, build a pretzel necklace and bring it. They're super fun, super awesome. I want to see these big, elaborate pretzel necklaces, and I want to take a selfie with you guys because I love it. I took a good number of selfies. I just walk up to somebody, can I get a selfie with you and your necklace? Because it's weird to just walk up to a stranger and take a picture of them, right? You don't want to do that. That's creepy.
And Ray, people are saying, who the heck are you?
Yeah, right? Nobody knows me like that.
You didn't like nibble on the necklace though, right? You didn't like nibble on their necklace or anything, did you?
Yeah, but I asked first. I'm like, that one looks tasty. Could I try it? No, I really didn't do that. I did, but it's fun to just say. Something I don't recall ever seeing before, but I saw this, and I want to encourage it for our event, is I saw folks walking around with Sharpies and writing tally marks on their wrist how many different beers they tried. And I don't know how I haven't seen it before.
Oh.
Or maybe I haven't just got too buzzed on what I was drinking to think about it. But I want to encourage folks to do that. I want it to blast out before the event how many beers we're going to have represented and encourage folks to try all of them and show proof by tally on their wrist. I want to see that evidence. How many of these beers did you try?
Can you guys see this?
So I think that'll be super awesome. Oh, is that the necklace you got for taster glasses?
Yep.
So I haven't seen this yet. That is awesome.
So that's one side, and then the logo of the sponsor is on the other side that bought these for us. So we're ordering 1,200 of them, so be prepared.
Woo! But what are you going to do for the other 1,200 people, Deb?
I know, right? I think we had, we had 500 tickets that we sold last year, and then, of course, then the, 130, 40 VIP. And so I just thought, we'll see. Well, Ray says we're going to sell 1,000 tickets. So I had to have the 200.
What's going to be, isn't it twice the size this year as last year, Ray? Isn't that what I heard?
Yep.
So close. So we had 13 breweries show. I wasn't engaged last year, but the event had 13 breweries show up. So far we have 15 on deck and I'm looking to get 5 more. So quick math, it would be 40% larger this year if we get 20 versus 13 last year. Does that match up, Mike?
And expanding the space, because I think you guys were all
larger, right?
Yeah, because you guys were all a little crammed, or the people.
Yeah, we were pretty cramped last year.
Yeah, so we're gonna almost take up the whole plaza.
Yes, so it's like I'm the kind of guy, I have to go to Dodger Stadium to slip into something comfortable. So I thought, you know, if we give the folks a little bit more of a footprint, they can have some space to kind of spread out. We're going to have, you know, some cornhole out there. some games to play. Again, we got, you know, more food coming out, so they need space to set up. I believe there's going to be more seating available this year than there was last year. And that just all requires space to make it comfortable for everybody. And I'm doing my best to facilitate that. Once we get all the final approvals, there's still several things in the works. I don't want to make a promise that isn't 100% set in stone yet. That's just not right. No, but we're absolutely moving towards that. So, and there may be a few other fun surprises. I really want to get some parachuting puppy dogs to come in.
Let's not distract from our beer, right? Come on. Our beer is the point here.
I'm really not going to do that, Debra. I promise. That was just a random fun thing to say. But now that I'm thinking about it, how cool would it be to have a dude just parachute down with a couple of kegs and just like land on the roof of the museum? I've never seen that in downtown Broken Arrow. So that might be a goal to shoot for next year, maybe 2025. Yeah. Obviously, I don't have time to facilitate that this year. But it's like, you know, if you're going to do something, man, make it memorable. And yeah. Who's going to forget something like that? Now, of course, Alex and Larry are going to be there. No one's going to forget this event anyway. I mean, these guys got a huge fan base. I'm sure they're going to be signing some autographs while they're giving out their beers.
Are you guys going to get your t-shirts?
We can do that. And if requested, Alex maybe will autograph one.
All right.
Oh, my gosh. I'm excited for that. And that is something that we're encouraging the breweries to do is if you have merch, bring it.
Yeah.
Bring your merch, right? I know you guys have t-shirts and hats and some other swag. Bring that stuff out, right? I'm encouraging that, and I'm going to encourage folks to buy a brewery hat and a t-shirt and some other stuff from you guys while you're out there. So that's a big deal for me to try to promote you guys and the work you're doing, you know, as we collaborate again for Soldier's Wish. So, and I'm going to keep drinking some of this beer, guys, because it's just too good to not consume, right? So also while I'm drinking the Terminal Velocity Doppelbock here again, some of your other beers that you guys have on tap, and I'm going to be honest, I don't remember names very well of anything at all ever. So I'll just be honest here, but I know you guys have an air quotes Kolsch. Is that right? I believe you have a Side-Eyed Saison, maybe a Shapeshifter Imperial Stout. What else do you guys, you know, keep like as far as year-round offerings?
Yeah. So yeah, our year-round offerings are that Kolsch, the Vanilla Blonde, the Seltzer, and then we always will have an IPA on the menu. We kind of rotate the IPA, and then we have that Doppelbock, of course. So everything else kind of comes in, you know, whenever we want to put something fun on or seasonally. So that's one thing we try to do is we keep a few things as staples year-round, but we also try to rotate as many of the taps as possible because that's more fun when you come in. To see new things and try new things.
Outstanding. So as far as, you know, takeaway, if somebody comes into the brewery, they find one they really enjoy. I've already told the folks that I've got a couple crowlers here. So that's a crowler in a can. Do you guys also have growlers available? Do you have like the larger glass options or is it just crowlers for take-home beers?
Yep, we have the 32-ounce growlers like you're drinking out of. And we have, you know, those 64-ounce glass growlers, yep. And then we also have a canning line now, and we should be starting to can sometime this month. And so we'll start to be able to pick up canned prepackaged six packs out of the tap room soon.
Oh, that's exciting! Yay! That's a big step, guys. So congratulations! Awesome. I know that's a big deal.
Yep. Yeah, we're very excited about it.
Get set up to do that.
What do you think your first beer will be in your cans?
Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde is the first one that's going to be canned.
Excellent work, man. That's good, dude. I'm so happy for you guys. That's awesome.
One of the first three is seltzer.
Oh,
yeah. The first three are Crazy Town Vanilla Blonde, or air quotes Kolsch, and the cherry limeade seltzer. Those are the first three that are going into cans.
Outstanding. And so just another quick word here. I know Debra is, she's messaging us on the side. She's having some technical difficulties as well. She may have to reboot her machine and come back in to join us here.
Alex, you want to touch on that bourbon barrel that we have right now, a limited release?
Yeah, so we have our Shapeshifter Imperial Stout on the menu right now, as you mentioned, but we also released with it this year. We released our bourbon barrel aged Shapeshifter from last year. It's been aging in bourbon barrels for 13 months. So we tapped it. We're running through it right now, so you can actually get a side by side tasting of that Imperial Stout and the same stout that's been aged in bourbon barrels. So it's pretty fun, cool thing that we can do in the tap room right now.
And what kind of barrel did you age it in?
They were aged in Jack Daniel's barrels, which I know is a little bit controversial as far as the bourbon front is concerned. I think technically it qualifies as a bourbon, but they don't like to be labeled as that. So we've had a few conversations with people about that in the tap room. I'm a beer guy, yeah. Not a whiskey guy, so I don't really have a lot of grounds to fight back on it. So,
man, it's a fun conversation. Something else. Yeah. Oh no, absolutely. Where did we have a tequila barrel aged beer? We've talked about it before. Was it Welltown? I think it was Welltown.
We've had several of those on the podcast. I think one of them, I want to say, came from Country Boys out of Kentucky. It was somewhere out of Kentucky. Now, maybe it was Lexington Brewing Company. I don't know, dude. Somewhere in Kentucky, we had one. I believe Welltown was another. And there's at least one more, dude.
Anyway, it's just a quick plug if you ever want to try that. The lagers and the pilsners turn out great. But I wish I could get some of that. Ray, you know, if they've got this on limited release, you could go down and Nook a brother up.
So I will do that for you, Mike.
We've got another one coming up, Nightmare on 12th.
Ooh.
Yeah, another Imperial Stout that we're going to release sometime this month or next. It's been aged in weeded bourbon barrels, so we're excited about that one. I think in the next coming year, I want to age some stouts in rum barrels. I really like what rum barrels do to stouts, so I want to try that this year, too.
Very cool. And I'm curious, how long do you plan on aging those?
8 months is typically kind of the minimum that we look at. I mean, this bourbon barrel stout that we have on the menu right now is actually our first ever barrel aged stout release, and we aged it for 13 months. So 8 months is kind of what we're considering the minimum time for us. But we kind of see how it goes, do some taste tests, kind of see where we like it, and go from there.
So I'm sure if it's anything like your other beers, it's going to be awesome. And I'm really looking forward to getting some of these again with my ice cream. I know it's what I do. So, and just, you know, for the first 2 years, Mike and I did this, we paired every beer we tried with some food. And I don't know how many circled back around with me to dessert. But anyway, we're talking about the Nook. And if you guys have never been there, if you've never been to Broken Arrow, let's make this a destination city for you. There's so much cool stuff here to see and do. Among those, of course, is the Nook. Now, you can find them at, I don't know their address. I have it here somewhere, don't I? God help me. I just closed the wrong screen. I closed my screen.
We're at 909.
I had it right in front of me.
We're at 909 South 12th Street in Broken Arrow. Southeast corner of 81st and Lynn Lane. It's a little industrial park. We're back in the back of the U there.
Hey, they're right by our presenting sponsor for the entire Shamrock event, Advanced Alarms.
Right next door.
Yes.
What a plug.
Right next door to the sponsor.
That's right. Hey, that worked out great. They're awesome community partners. I graduated with Shannon, and then Clint's a couple of years younger than us, so we've kind of known them most of our lives. So they're pretty great guys.
They're our good neighbors.
So thank you so much for bailing me. You think I've done this enough, I would just know exactly where to go to see the address. So thank you, Alex, for knowing the address of your business. I appreciate that. Also, if you can't make it to Broken Arrow, visit them at www.nookbrewco.com. And you can find them at Facebook and Instagram at Nook Brew Co. So you can support local from anywhere you're at. And I encourage you to do so. Give them some likes, follows, and shares, and show them some love. They are just an awesome brewery, awesome group of guys and gals that run the facility. And I'm so glad that they're here. So good time. So just real quick, Debra, talk again, remind our listeners and folks that, you know, may just tune in halfway or just whatever. Tell us quickly again about Shamrock the Rose District and again, what we're doing all of this for. And then we'll look to close out our episode tonight.
Yes. So Shamrock the Rose is a street festival. It's in its ninth year. It'll be March 11th in the Rose District on Main Street in Broken Arrow. The beer garden goes from 5 to 9 p.m. We have currently 15 breweries. Thank you, Ray. And more to come. I'm just sure of it. We have lots of great bands and street vendors and probably about a dozen food trucks, and it all benefits Soldier's Wish. And if you have someone that you'd want to nominate, you can go to soldierswish.org and you can nominate someone that you think deserves to be to receive a wish. And we'll actually be granting a wish on stage at 6:30 the day of the event, which if you're in the beer garden, you can stop. Well, you can drink and stop and watch the granting of the wish because the stage is right there. So that's pretty awesome. To date, the event has raised $100,000for local veterans. And that's all. And it's mainly because of you guys, the breweries, because if you didn't volunteer your time and your product, we wouldn't be able to sell tickets that go directly to Soldier Switch. So thank you guys. You don't know how much I appreciate how much you guys do for us.
Come visit us at the beer garden. You're right by the stage. You can see all the music. You can see the wish granted. It's a great place to hang out.
Yes.
Absolutely.
And it's not going to hail. It's not going to hail this year. So that's going to be great.
Yay! We're super excited. It's a cool event. It's for a great cause. So we're happy to do it.
Yeah, I appreciate you guys. I got to give a shout out to some of the other breweries. We have a lot of them here. So I'm just going to call. I'm looking at a spreadsheet right now. I'm just reading top to bottom, so this is not special to anybody. I'm not leaving anybody out. So I just want to preface with that.
You're going to read Nook twice, right? Right at the top?
Oh, yes.
So actually, on my spreadsheet, there are 100% in order by sign up, right? That's just how I organize my workbooks. But I've got the Nook. We've got High Gravity Brew, Muskogee Brewing Company, Rough Tail, Fat Toad, we got Babco, the Broken Air Brewing Company, Brew Buddies, Nothing's Left, Welltown, Anthem, Skydance, and plenty more. So, super excited. And again, I didn't leave anybody out on purpose. I promise this is all being blasted on social media. A lot of it's already out there. We're going to keep pumping it out and supporting the breweries that are supporting the cause. Because really, we want to send as many people your way as possible as a result of your help. The craft beer community is awesome about supporting breweries, especially when they go out to support a cause. I'm sure you guys have seen evidence of that. And really, I want to do what I can with my platform to send as many folks your way as possible.
Great cause. Super awesome evening. Super fun. Really relaxed night. Come visit us.
So we'll do, Mike, any final thoughts before I look to close this one out, my dude?
No, I'm just going to remind everybody they go to thebabuzz.com, and then from there you can find right on the main page, it's the Shamrock for the event. So it's right there on the main page. It's the BA Buzz, and get more information and just say thank you, everybody, for coming. And, you know, thank you for dealing with my technical difficulties to start off with. But, I had a lot of fun, and it's good to see these guys again from the Nook. Been there a couple of times, and Debra, it was nice to meet you as well.
Nice to meet you.
So I'm going to echo everything Mike said, but just say I'm going to echo what Mike said because it takes less time. So Alex, Larry from the Nook, I very much appreciate you guys joining us tonight. Thank you for making awesome beers. I always look forward to consuming them. Debra, thank you for taking the time to hang out. It's super awesome to have you on with us. I had a lot of fun.
Thanks.
You're welcome. I want to encourage everybody to get on the social medias, visit the Nook because they are awesome. I don't just say that to say it. It's because, well, it's true. So find them. Damn it. I lost my show notes again. Oh,
Thanks for having us.
You're welcome. Absolutely. Thank you for hanging out. I appreciate you guys. And I'm shooting from the hip here because I closed the wrong window twice now. Golly, I'm not smart.
While you're looking, so hey, the Nook also does a really great thing. They host the fire. Speaking of fire pits, the Eagle Ops host their fire pit nights there. So that's really cool.
Oh, that's right. They're a Rally Point location.
Anybody for Eagle Ops, we're a Rally Point location. So come on out.
Yep.
Yes. So here, I got it in front of me again. I talked to you guys enough on Instagram. I should just know this. But find them on Facebook and Instagram at Nook Brew Co. Or again, visit their website, nookbrewco.com. Go in and say hi to Alex and Larry. Show them some love. Buy like 18 crawlers of your favorite beer and or beers. Just get a shopping cart. No one cares.
Shelter.
Load it up.
Or so.
Get some seltzer. Buy a gallon of their seltzer. Do it.
We'll help you wheel it to your car.
See, great beer and awesome customer service. That's what I'm talking about. So we're going to close this one out. Buy your tickets online. Get them advanced for Shamrock the Rose District and our awesome beer garden. While you're at it, if you're listening to us on Apple Podcasts, be sure to give us that 5-star rating. Leave us your comments. Mike and I love to read those. We appreciate your support from all over the U.S. and the world. I think we're still at 43 or 44 countries, Mike. How cool is that? Also, if you're tuning in from iHeartRadio, thank you. Google, Stitcher, Spotify, all the above. We love you guys from wherever you listen and whenever you listen. And do me a solid, please, please, please don't drink and drive, but do drink local. And we will catch y'all on the next episode of Craft Beer Bucket List.
Adios. This episode of Craft Beer Bucket List was partially supported by ParksNPints.com, a nonprofit supporting research for public lands. Find out more about Parks and Pints by visiting their Facebook or Instagram at Parks and Pints. That's ParksNPints.